Hello everyone, welcome to my channel. On this episode, I'm going to talk about an ancient bath which dates back to 1875 when Qajar's dynasty were ruling over Iran. This structure has 1,102 floor area and consisted of several parts, included grand changing room, major bath, and a distinguished roof. Each of these sections has subsidiary parts that I will elaborate more on them down the line. But first, let me tell you a little bit about the main elements of architecture in the past. During that time, each city has five major parts, included mosque, market, resident areas, water storage, and public bath. This structure has a main entrance with beautiful patterns which leads to a vestibule. Then we have grand changing room. I should mention that corridors which connected the vestibule to the grand changing room are meanderous with 90 degree angles to avoid flowing the hot air outside of the chamber, in addition to avoid changing the temperature precipitously. Grand changing room was used by many people in that time. This section also used as an establishment for providing massage. This part leads to the major bath by meanderous halls. In those halls, we have some subsidiary rooms like praying room, shaving room, restroom, and phlebotomy room. This section is decorated with splendid murals and plaster motifs on the walls. All materials that were used in the building are resistant to moisture. There are unique colorful tiles which double down the beauty of this part. In the major bath section, we have several parts to maintain the water and keep it warm. As you can see, there are two pools at both sides for maintaining the water, and we have a separated room to make the water warm. This part equipped with copper bowls, and under this part there is furnace to burn the wood and keep the water warm. Not to mention that copper metal was used due to its special features, which make the thermal energy created by furnace flow easily and make the water warm so soon. There are some channels that connect pools to each other. These channels were made out of unique materials to avoid water leakage. There is another interesting fact about this part, which is the smoke isn't directly led to the chimney. Instead, there are some channels that lead the smoke of the furnace to the chimneys. These channels also made out of copper and located underground. So this feature made the floor of the structure warmer. In this section, there are some secluded parts that were designated to upper class citizens. There are other subsidiary sections that are connected to the major bath with their own entrance, corridors, restrooms, bath and changing room, which were used by middle class. Main entrance has carved patterns on the walls. Some of them look like plants, flowers, and animals with hunting themes, because in that time it was a popular hobby. We have a distinguished roof in this structure. In this part, we have many perforated domes with special glasses as skylight. These glasses are matte to avoid the inside of the bath being visible. Skylights were created in dome shapes to absorb sunlight from every angle. In that time, ceilings were built in arch form. This feature has several benefits. Firstly, arch form has increased the durability and endurance against the pressure. Secondly, in case of precipitation, arch form avoids accumulation of water on the roof. In other parts of the roof, we have a separated part with its own channels that lead to a well, which is used as a water supply for this building. This roof has a steep level, and this feature gathers the water of precipitation and feeds it to the well. This was a brilliant method invented by architectures to supply the water of the well. Thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed this episode. Let me know your opinion in the comment section, and if you like, please subscribe to my channel and wait for new videos.